Good evening, everybody, and welcome to local television, which tonight comes to you from the parish of Killamartra. We are here in Findus House in Ballybuig, in the home of Michael and Mary O'Sullivan and family. First of all, I would like to introduce you to the O'Sullivan family. First of all, we have Michael O'Sullivan.
Hello.
The man of the house himself. And next we have Mary O'Sullivan, the woman of the house.
Hello.
Mary. And next, Peter O'Sullivan. And the next in the family is Norm O'Sullivan.
No.
And next is Myriad.
No.
And then we have Sean.
No.
And we have Michelle.
No.
And Sinead.
No.
And the baby, Claire.
Hello.
That's it. Well, now, we have a great program of music, songs, dances and recitations ready for you tonight, and we'll now start off the ball rolling with music from the Primrose Sound. Now, next we'll have a song from Donald Cronin Dún de Ráir, and the song is Will You Go, Lassie Go.
Oh, the summertime is coming,
And the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain thyme rolls around the blooming heather. Will ye go, lassie, go? And we'll all go together to pluck wild mountain thyme. All around the bloomin' heather, will ye go, lassie, go? If my true love she were gone, I would surely find another where the wild mountain thyme rolls around the bloomin' heather. Will ye go, lassie, go? And we'll all go together to pluck wild mountain thyme. All around the blooming heather, will ye go, lassie, go? I will build my love a tower near yon pure and crystal fountain, and around it I will pile all the flowers of the mountain. Will ye go, lassie, go? And we'll all go together to pluck wild mountain thyme. All around the blooming heather, will ye go, lassie, go? Oh, the summer time is coming, and the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain thyme rolls around the blooming heather. Will ye go, lassie, go?
Now next, we'll have a few ballads from the Killamartra ICA Ballad Group, accompanied on guitar by Willem Burke.
Oh,
Now, next on the program, we'll have a song from a man who needs no introduction whatsoever to local television, because he's always there with a song, and that is the man himself, Dermot Dineen.
Go sell the cow and pig a grow to take you far away. Your dear old parents you must leave behind. Go seek your fortune, darling, in a land beyond the tide. For Aunt Paddy's land, but poverty you'll find. These were the words my father said the day I sailed away. That sad farewell, it's in my memory still. I packed my bundle on my back and away forevermore. From that little old mud cabin on the hill. For the roof is thatched with straw and the walls are white as snow. The tar fire boils the pot, I see it still. Old Ireland grieving in my heart, the place where I was born. In that little old mud cabin on the hill. I think I see the tar fire, it attracts my father's gaze. My dear old mother sitting by his side. His pipe alit the smoke ascend, he's thinking of the time when he sent his darling by across the tide. No more we'll sing the merry songs we did in days of yore, with the music of the bagpipes loud and shrill. No more we'll dance the merry dance upon the kitchen floor. In that little old mud cabin on the hill. For the roof is thatched with straw and the walls are white as snow. The tar fire boils the pot, I see it still. Old Ireland's grieving in my heart, the place where I was born. In that little old mud cabin on the hill.
Now, the next item we have here, five musicians, Willem Burke on guitar, John Hoare on fiddle, Andrew Connell on banjo, Connie Connell on fiddle, and Pat Connell on tin whistle. They'll give us a selection of slides.
Thank you.
Next, we have a song from Kathleen Bohan from County Carty. And the name of the song is One Day at a Time.
I'm only human, I'm just a woman. Help me believe in what I must be and all that I am. Show me the stairway I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Do you remember when we walked among men? Well, Jesus, you know, if you're looking below, it's worse now than then. Pushing and shoving and calling my mind. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time.
Now next, we'll have a selection of music on the accordions from the O'Sullivan Girls, Drum Rig, Denise and Catherine. Now next we'll have a song from Nell Murphy from Crookroo, and the name of the song is The Banks of Clardy.
As I roamed out one evening, all in the month of May, through lonesome groves and hedges, I carelessly did stray. I overheard a damsel in a sorrow she complained. It is on the banks of Clardy, my darling, do remain. It is on the banks of Clardy, fair maid, whereon you stand. Do not depend on Johnny, for he's a false young man. Do not depend on Johnny, for he won't meet you here. So come with me to yon green woods, and no danger need you fear. If Johnny he were here tonight, he'd keep me from all harm. He's on the field of battle, all in his uniform. He's on the field of battle, and his foes he do defy. Like the roaring kings of honor, going through the wars of Troy. It is 6 long months and more now since Johnny left the shore. He's crossing the main ocean where the foaming billows roar. He's crossing the main ocean for honor and for fame. And I was told his ship was wrecked down by the coast of Spain. When she heard those mournful words, she fell in deep despair. With the ringing of her hands and the tearing of her hair, saying, if Johnny he has left me and no other man I'll take, through lonesome groves and hedges I'll wander for his sake. When the traveller heard those mournful words, he could no longer stand. Falling in her arms, crying, Betsy, I'm the man. I'm your inconstant lover, the cause of all your pain. And since we've met on Clardy's banks, we never shall part again.
Now next, we'll have a song from Pather McSweeney Cathaoirceen, and the name of the song is Matt Highland.
Thank you, Jen. There was a lord who lived in the town, who had a lovely handsome daughter. She was courted by a fair young man, who was a servant to her father. But when her parents came to know, they swore they'd ban him from the island. The maid, she knew that her heart would break were she to part from her Matt Highland. So straight away to her love she goes, up to his room for to awaken. Saying, arise, arise, and go, my love, this very night you will be taken. I overheard my parents say, in spite of me they would transport you. So arise, arise, and go, my love, I wish to God I'd gone before you. They both sat down upon the bed, just for the sight of one flower. And there above did either speak, as down their cheeks the tears did shower. She laid her head upon his breast, and round his neck her arms entwined them. No duke or lord or earl I'll wait for you, my own Matilda. One night the lord and his daughter fair discouraged alone in her bedchambers, saying, I'll give you leave for to bring him back, since no one else can win your favor. She wrote a letter then in haste, for him her heart was still repining. They brought him back to the church they went, and made a lord of young Matilda Sheen.
Now next we'll have a song from William Burke, and the name of the song is The Last Thing on My Mind. Steadily growing, please don't go.
I didn't mean to be unkind. Yes, you know that was the last thing on my mind. You know that was the last thing on my mind.
Now, next, we have Marion Kelleher from Dundurayrk. And Marion is going to dance a reel, and she'll be accompanied on the accordion by her brother Adrian. Now next we'll have a song from the two young O'Sullivan girls, Michelle and Sinead.
Happy birthday, hope we hit the trees for Augustus in the toy. Toshy in the land of your Toshy in the lee. Teddy Bjork Oli, Teddy Bjork Bwi. Gorty Chia Hion, Agus Gorty Chia Hwyd. Gorty Chia Lof, Agus Gorty Chia Dwyn. Ta si yn y lena fio, ta si yn y li. Teddy Bjork Oli, Teddy Bjork Bwi. Hori gan doctor y gargynti. Cawyl Teddy Bjork, Teddy Bjork Bwi.
Now next we'll have a song from Peg Crowley from Gortnabinge, and she's going to sing an Irish song for us, and the name of it is Crucha Glas na Héireann.
Tan saurig shilis y shade Enw fer fwed i lan yn ael Ta'n grian eich sil siwg y gleigal Sel un y lehif nes yn tir O is minig mes mi'n tu ar ffile Eir a siawns ar cord y mae glew Mas ŵl y son is mae hi'n na Nag o ni fwy chrwch y na heran Crwch y glas na heran Landre mas quilt y crel On caran ac nairel Sieng na ffeir e Ig fil y har sailen Our mind is sorry. fin kruk ik drömlen är bak i det lina har salle härgets leor och is kamma mat hamidig fylle gan bingen är bak i damar Hans lein to go for il nar gnavin na go ni fi fruche na heren kruche glas na heren landre mes kill to crave on kara Jing the fayere, ik vila har sale. Grace green dar yola, luske herim na mara. Os nar fada kame mitzla. Is a valle fi kruche na heiran.
Now next we'll have the junior figure dancers, and they're going to dance for us the Morris Reel. Thank you. Now, next, we have Gormlet Buckley and Arne Connell, and they're going to play for us a hornpipe and a slide. Now next we have Denny Reardon from County Carty, and Denny is going to give us a recitation, and the name of it is The Mixed Marriage.
I was born and reared in Sandy Row, a Lyle Arns Prad, and I stood for good King William, that noble man of God. My motto, no surrender. My flag, the Union Jack, and every 12th I proudly marched to Finnehan back, a loyal son of Ulster, a true blue, that was me, prepared to fight and prepared to die for faith and liberty. As well as that, a Linfield man, as long as I can mind, and I had no time for Catholics or any of that kind. Then one night in Bangor, I met wee Rosie Green. And the moment I laid eyes on her, I knew she was my queen. And when I saw she fancied me, my mind went all abuzz, and I clean forgot to ask what her religion was. Well, the next time that we met, I told her I'm a pretty stanch and true. And she said, I'm a Catholic and just as stanch as you. Well, the words were harsh and bitter, but suddenly, like this, centuries of hatred were forgotten in a kiss. Well, I knew that our love would only bring us trouble and distress, but nothing in the world would make me love wee Rosie less. So I saved a bit of money as quickly as I could. And I asked her if she'd marry me. And by gosh, she said she would. Well, then the trouble really started. Her folks were raving mad. And when mine heard about it, they were twice as bad. My father said that from that day on he'd hang his head in shame. And by a strange coincidence, Rosie's father said the same. And my mother cried her eyes out. And she said, I rue the day that I let a papish hussy steal my loyal heart away. And Rosie's mother said, when she recovered from the blow, that she'd rather see the devil than a man from Sandy Row. Well, we were married in a Catholic church. T'was on the other side of town. That's the way Rosie wanted it. And of course, I couldn't let her down. But the priest was very nice to me, and he made me feel at home. I think he pitied both of us, for all people didn't come. Well, the room we went to live in had nothing but the walls, and t'was far away from Sandy Row and further from the falls, but that's the way it had to be, for both of us knew well that back there among our folk, life would just be hell. But life out there for Rosie was lonely, well I knew, and of course we had our quota of religious problems too. At dinner time on Friday, when Rosie gave me fish, I looked at it, and then at her, and I said, that was not my dish. I remember well what she said to me. You've got to pay the price. To eat no meat on Friday is but a poor wee sacrifice to make for Christ who died for us on that Friday long ago. Anyway, I ate the fish and turned bad, you know. Well, on Sunday, she got up for mass, but I lay on in bed. But Rosie wouldn't hear of it. You must go to church, she said. Well, we left the house together, but we parted down the line. She went after her church and I went after mine. Well, the weeks and months went quickly by, and then there came the day when Rosie upped and told me that a child was on the way. Well, that night, we knelt together and we asked the Lord above to give our child two great gifts, confidence and love. Well, the rows before the wedding were infinitely mild compared to the rumpus that was raised about the child. Rosie's people came to say that the child should be RC, and my people said it should be a Protestant like me. The child must be a Catholic and the child must be a prad. But the last and loudest voice I heard was the mighty voice of God. And unto his great wisdom, I had to bow my head. For an hour after it was born, the poor wee child was dead. That night, I knelt at Rosie's side. And just before the dawn, I kissed her as she left me for to join her angel son. And then my heart was broken amid those lonely walls, far away from Sandy Row and far away from the falls. But that was many years ago, long years of grief and pain, when I'd have given all I had for to see her face again. But my loneliness is over now. I'll see her soon, I know. For the doctor told me yesterday that I hadn't far to go. But when I go up yonder, they let me in, I hope. But if they ask me who I am for, King William or the Pope, I'm going to take no chances. But I'll tell them straight and fair that I'm a loyal Ulster Protestant that loved the papish air. And one way or another, I know they let me through. and Rosie will be waiting there, and our little angel too. And then the child will lead us, the papist and the prad, up the steps together into the arms of God.
Now next, I'm going to play two tunes on the accordion, and my little girl Gobnet is going to accompany me on the tin whistle and the first tune. The first tune will be My Irish Soldier Boy, and then I'll play The Gentle Maiden. Next, we have the young lady of the house to sing a song, Norma O'Sullivan here, and she's going to sing The Fenian Gun.
It hung above the kitchen fire, its barrels long and brown, and one day with a boy's desire, I climbed and took it down. My father's eyes with anger flashed. What have you done? I wish you'd left it where it was. That's my old Fenian gun. I looked it o'er and o'er. I placed it on my shoulder, and I marched across the floor. My father's anguish softened, he shared my boyish fun. Ah, well, he said, 'tis in your breed, like that old Fenian gun. I remember 67 well, he said, when lads like me all thought we'd strike another blow to set old Ireland free. But broken more our golden hopes, I was long once on the run. For it did good work for Ireland then, that brown old Fenian gun. I placed it o'er the fire once more, I heard my father sigh. I knew his thoughts were turning back on days now long gone by. And then I vowed within my heart I'd be my father's son. And whenever Ireland wants my aid, I'll hold that Fenian gun. That's years ago I've grown a man and withered many a gale. Those last long years I spent inside at loomy English jail. I've done my part, I'll do it still until the fight is won. And when Ireland's free, she'll bless the men that held that Fenian gun.
Now, once again, we have the Primrose Sound, and this time Pat is going to sing Way Down in the Meadows.
I'm just like any other chap. I'd like an Irish young girl with eyes so bright and step so light and teeth as white as pearl. Her golden hair hung down her back, her cheeks just like the rose. And I met her in the meadows where the bluebells grow, way down in the meadows where the bluebells grow. My charming little Flo, when the moon is shining bright, together we will go away down to the meadows where the bluebells grow. Her, she spoke to me. We spoke of love divine. Then I picked up courage. I asked her to be mine. She said that she would not consent. But tomorrow I'll let you know if you'll miss me in the meadows where the bluebells grow, away down in the meadows where the bluebells grow. That's where I first met my charming little Flo, and settle down in life. We live in peace and harmony, away from war and strife. We've got one only daughter, to whom we've christened Flo, to remind us of the meadows where the bluebells grow. Away down in the meadows where the bluebells grow, that's where I first met my charming little Flo. When the moon is shining bright, together we will go away down to the meadows where the bluebells grow. Away down to the meadows where the bluebells grow.
Next, we have the Killamartra Ballad Group, and they're going to sing for us two songs. The first one is the Connemara Cradle Song, and then Colleen.
Thank you.
Now next we have Joan and Elizabeth to sing Leaving My Nancy. Next we have the junior set dancers and they're going to dance a polka set. Next, we'll have a song from Peg Crowley once again, and the name of the song is My Lovely Irish Rose.
winding river winds its way close to an Irish home and mingles by Stradalty Bay where flows the Atlantic foam. 'Twas in the spot close to the coast where the river gently flows I bade farewell to my own dear girl, my lovely Irish rose. Oh, Carden fair beyond compare, I never will forget. Oh, Carden fair beyond compare, sure I think I see it yet. I'd rather stray by Old Mill Bay just at the evening close. On a summer's night, 'twas my heart's delight, my lovely Irish rose. Oh, Mary dear, I'm lonely here without you all the while. I miss your kind and loving heart. I miss Irish smile. Before I go to sleep at night and before my eyes I close, I pray that God will guide me right, my lovely Irish rose.
Now, once again, from John Hoare, Andrew Connell, William Burke, and Pat Connell, and Connie Connell, we'll have a few reels. Thank you. we'll have a song from Tommy Vaughan from Kilfeanchan. And the name of the song is Ballyneety's Walls.
The night was dark round Limerick, and everything was still. 'Twas for the foe in ambush, we lay beside the hill. Like lions bold we waited to dash upon our prey. As we rode with Sarsfield at our head, at the dawning of the day. From Dublin came the four men, with guns and warlike store, for to take the town of Limerick, enough and 10 times more. But little was their notion that they might meet their doom, as we rode with Sarsfield at our head, way down through Aisley Bloom. At the lonely hour of midnight, each man leapt on his deed, and through the town of Cullen we dashed with lightning speed. And o'er the hills we thundered to Ballyneety's walls, where lay the foe securely, with guns and arms and all. They asked us for the password, we said Sarsfield every man. And here I am, our general cried, as down on them we ran. O'erhead the cloudless firmament, the moon and stars gave light. And for the battle of the Boyne, we had revenge that night. Loud laughed our gallant general, as we swiftly rode away. And many health we drank to him, in Limerick town next day. Here's another health to Sarsfield, who led us one and all, to blow up the Royal Artillery by Ballyneety's walls.
Now next, we have Dennis Lynch from Rennerie, and he's going to play a jig and a polka.
Thank you.
Now, once again, we'll have Marion Kelleher from Tunsbridge, accompanied on the accordion by her brother, Adrian, and she's going to dance a double jig. Next, we have Christy Leahy from Rainerie, and he's going to sing for us Dingle Bay.
The sun is sinking to the westward. The fleet is leaving Dingle Shore. I watch the men row in the as they work the fishing grounds near Skelligmoor. All through the night men toil until the day breaks, while at home their wives and sweethearts kneel and pray that God may guard them and protect them and send them safely back to Dingle Bay. I can see the green isle of Valentia. I mind the caves around Loch Ay, the gallard swinging with abandon as they watch the silver store that comes their way. I can see a ship on the horizon. She is sailing to a country far away. On board are exiles feeling lonely as they bid a fond farewell to Dingle Bay. Many years have passed since I went westward, and time has left me old and gray. I sit and muse about my childhood and the happy place I spent near Dingle Bay. In memory I see the hill of Brandon, and the isle of Inishmore seems far away. I'm always dreaming of my homeland and that little spot it's been near Dingle Bay.
Hi, Christine.
Now, next, we're going to have Denise O'Sullivan to dance a jig, and she's accompanied on the accordion by her sister, Catherine. From Liam Burke and Connie Connell and his daughter Anya, we'll have a jig, and then after that, Connie and Willie will play two reels.
Thank you.
Now next we have Siobhan Cooney from Gortinaden, and Siobhan is going to play a slow air and a double G. Now we'll have Kathleen Vaughan once again to sing us another song, and this time she's going to sing for us The Fields of Athenry.
By lonely prison wall I heard a young girl calling, my good dear, sending you away. You stole rebellion's corn, so the young might see the morn, and the prison ship lies waiting in the bay. Low lie the fields of Athenry, when first we watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing, we had dreams and songs to sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. By lonely prison wall I heard a young man calling, nothing matters, Mary, when you're free. Against the famine and the crown I rebelled, they ran me down. But you must raise our child with dignity. Low lie the fields of Athenry, when first we watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing, we had dreams and songs to sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. By lonely harbour wall she watched the last star falling, as the prison ship sailed out against the sky. Then she waited, hoped and prayed for her love on Botany Bay. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. Low lie the fields of Athenry, when first we watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing, we had dreams and songs to sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry.
Now once again we'll have a song from Diarmaid Dineen, and the name of the song this time is The Stuttering Lovers. A wee bit over the lea, me lads, a wee bit over the lea. The birds went into the poor man's corn. I fear they'll never be seen, me lads. I fear they'll never be seen. All came a bonny wee lass, she was all so fair. She went into the poor man's corn to see if the lass was there, me lad, to see if the birds were there. All came a bonny wee lad, he was a fisherman's son, and he went into the poor man's corn to see if the lass was there, me lad, see if the lass was there. He put his arm around her waist, he kissed her three times o'er. Out spoke the bonny wee lass, I fear it is a sin, me lad, I fear it is a sin. Now came the poor old man, he was all tattered and torn. Well, if that's the way you're minding the bird, sure I'll mind them myself in the morn, me lad. I'll mind them myself in the morn.
Goodbye, dear friend.
Now, once again, we'll have another recitation from Denny Reardon. And the name of it, the recitation this time, is The Old Mountain Dew.
A drop of that brew called the old mountain dew, your troubles it quickly should banish, to cure all your ills without any pills, and your aches and pains that soon vanish. For 'twould fill you with glee, and if you were blind, you could see. And if you were dumb, your tongue should loosen, your brain should clear, and if you were deaf, you could hear, and your heart would beat strong in your bosom. What is as ancient a brew as you ever knew, and it was our forefathers' delight to sit at the fire and drink up a bowl of that stuff that's made by moonlight. Now once Shoon McCool fell from his mule, and they laid him out low in a stretcher, and a doctor from town, a man of renown, said he's bad, his wife go and fetch her. For his heart it beats low, and his breathing is slow, and the tick of his pulse is quite tender. And he said with a sigh, his temperature is high, and his chance of survival is slender. Now his comrades so brave, they looked very grave, as they gazed on their chieftain with sorrow. Is there nothing to do for old general so true, for dead he will be in tomorrow? Then up spoke a man mile, and he said, kneel and bile. For that doctor he's surely mistaken, and away he did run like a son of a gun, for he knew of a place that was making. And he never drew breath till he came to a hut or a sat of a cave in the mountain, and from beneath a rock he pulled out a crack of that stuff, 'twas clear as the fountain. And soon he was back to that tumble-down shack, where Fionn was lying low in his slumber, and he gave him a sup from that famous cup, and that was the sup to remember. Now his comrades stood round, and they gazed at the ground. But then they all looked amazed, for soon Fionn McCool called for his mule, and with his hounds he went off with the chase. So now, my kind friends, each story it ends, but if ever it happens to you that you're doling out and your spirits are low, try a drop of the old mountain dew. For 'twill cure all your ills without any pills, and your summer will linger on later, your hens they will lay, and your cocks they will pay, but give them a drop of the crater.
Thank you.
Now, after that lively set from the senior dancers, we are now back once again to Donal Cronin for a song. And this time he's going to sing The Fox.
Well, the fox went out on a stormy night, and he prayed the moon to give him light. He'd many a mile to go that night before he reached the town, oh. The ducks and the geese that were kept therein. One of years are gonna grease my chin before I leave this town, oh town, oh town, oh. One of years are gonna grease my chin before I leave this town, oh. He grabbed a grey goose by the neck and he threw a duck across his back. He didn't mind the quack, quack, quack and the legs all dangling down, oh. Down, oh, down, oh. He didn't mind the quack, quack, quack and the legs all dangling down, oh. Old Mother Flipper-Flopper went out of bed. Out of the window she stuck her head, crying, John, John, the grey goose is gone and the fox is on his way to the town, oh. Town, oh, town, oh. Crying, John, I'd better flee with my kill, or they'll soon be on me. Trail, oh, trail, oh, trail, oh. The foxy said I'd better flee with my kill, or they'll soon be on my trail, oh. When the foxy came to his cozy den, there were the little ones, 8, 9, 10. They said, Dad, you better go back again, cause it must be a mighty fine town, oh, town, oh, town, oh. They said, Dad, you better go back again, cause it must be a mighty fine town, oh.
Now, from Adrian Keller, we'll have a few waltzes on the accordion. Now, from Patsy Sullivan drum rig, we're going to have two tunes on the accordion, a waltz and a jig.
Thank you.
Now again, we'll have another song from Nell Murphy, and the name of the song this time is Arise Bonnie Lassie, We'll Bundle and Go.
At the foot of Greenock, where the Clyde runs smoothly, where lads and gay lasses sing all in a day, I have come, lovely Annie, to give you the last offer. So make up your mind without further delay. Your mother is out, and the house is just lonely. This night you will rue if you answer me no. Sure it is in your power for to be my own dearie. So arise, bonnie lassie, we'll bundle and go. It is true I have courted Miss Nancy and Kitty and other gay lasses at markets and fairs, but none of them all set my bosom a dingling like you, lovely Annie, between hope and despair. My father, he died and he left me his blessing. He told me never wed any but you. I took his advice, though a long time I've courted, and I always then found you but constant and true. Contentment and pleasure give air to my kindred. My heart is decoyed, come hither with woe. I find myself happy in having my dearie. Then arise, bonnie lassie, we'll bundle and go. Her put in their heart began for to give in, and tears from her eyes in abundance did flow. Sure it's hard to be pleased between love and beauty, and only for that I would willingly go. My father and mother no doubt will be angry, and my fortune they'll keep, sheets and blankets also. My mother will rage and forever disown me, and only for that I would willingly go. A fig for excuses, come pack up your cottons, through moors and through marshes we surely must gang. There's no time for stopping, for chatting or talking, for the day will be dawning before we are gone. Your father and mother no doubt will be angry, and your fortune to you in its course it will flow. When they'll see your children around the fire sitting, so now are you ready and willing to go? Then a love gave a blink, and at length we were married in peace and contentment. The years fled along, her innocence Sin spirit was cheerful and funny, and he did his endeavors to delight her along. He did his endeavors for to please his own dearie, and their love for each other in abundance did flow. So may God bless the day she left father and mother and took his advice for to bundle and go.
Once again, we'll have a song from Willie Burke, and this time it's the Grainmoor Hare.
Daylight. I blame Mac.
Now, at this stage, I'll call on the man of the house himself, Michael O'Sullivan, to give us the song. And the song this time is The Rose of San Antone.
Deep within my heart lies a melody, a song of old San Antone, where in dreams I live with a memory beneath the stars all alone. It was there I found, beside the Alamo, enchantment strange as the blue up above, a moonlit past that only she could know, still hears my broken song of love. Moon in all your splendor, know only my heart. Call back my rose, rose of San Antone. Lips so sweet and tender, like petals falling apart. Speak once again of my love, my own broken heart. Empty words I know, still live in my heart all alone. For that moonlit past by the Alamo, and rose, my rose of San Antone.
Now we'll have a song from the young man of the house, Sean Sullivan, and the song he's going to sing for us is Tons of Bright Gold.
To Carrigie alone, fine summer's morning I stray, to view the green fields and trees affording fine shade. When who should I meet but a handsome and charming young dame, and for tons of bright gold, of course, I won't tell her name. If I am a groom and all the fine lands by the lee, and all the fine farms from Balani to Ballinagree, I give the man more, this charming young maid to obtain, and for tons of bright gold, of course, I won't tell her name. It was down by the lawn, and my darling was herding her kye. I'd like to be nearer to hear her singing so fine. Her notes are like music, I'm sure that her voice is the same, and for tons of bright gold, of course, I won't tell her name. When I and my girl together will act our joint, the clergy well paid for the labor considered so light. Until that day indeed, her name will a secret remain, and for tons of bright gold, of course, I will tell her name.
Now, alas, we have come to the end of the show. And at this point, I'd like to say a sincere thank you to Michael and Mary O'Sullivan for having us here in Findus House tonight. It was very kind of them to have us here. I would also like to say a sincere thank you to all the artists who took part here tonight and came along to make this show possible. I wish them a safe home. I'd also like to thank the man himself, the man behind the camera, who was so patient with us all night. And not forgetting the woman of the house herself, who served us teas during the night to keep us going. For that, we are very grateful. I hope you at home enjoyed the show as we really enjoyed it here making the program. We hope to be back with you again in the not too distant future. Until then, I'll say good night. God bless you, one and all. And now we'll play out with the Primrose Sound and a few polkas. Good night, and God bless you, one and all again.